Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, in this video we'll discuss that when the body rotates at different points, how the linear velocity and angular velocity change. Which one is constant, which one is variable, that we'll understand that. Hello students, let us understand the variation of linear velocity and angular velocity. This is a very conceptual part of the to understand rotational motion. What it says that if I consider a rigid body, if suppose that this is my rigid body. How to define a rigid body? So the definition of rigid body is that any body which cannot be changed or deformed, whatever may be the external force. That means the body's shape, size cannot be changed. In other words, you say that when you take any two point in the body, whatever you force you want to apply from outside, you do that, but the distance between those two points will remain same, even under the application of external force. Practically, nobody is perfectly rigid, and practically we take a stone or a piece of iron that we take as a rigid body. Generally they don't change shape by application of small amount of force. So suppose that I have an object like this, is a rigid body, and suppose that this object is rotating about this axis. This is the axis of rotation. So this is the axis of rotation. What is the axis of rotation? Is basically that if I have an object and if this is the object at the different points, I will just consider two, three points, one here. If I talk about this point, then this point will rotate. If the axis is rotating like that, anti-clockwise, then this object will rotate like this. This point will also move in a circular path. As this body, whole body, whatever its shape, irregular shape, but when it rotates, the point actually completes the circular motion. Though the shape of the object is not circular, but during its rotation, every point will make a circular motion. If I talk about a point over here, so this point will also move in a circular path. So as you see that each and every point will have circular motion, whether the point is here or the point is here, all will have a circular motion. So the axis of rotation is that if I talk about this particle rotating about this is the center of rotation. This particle rotating about this point, this particle rotating about this at center, this particle rotating about this at the center. So if I consider all those particles at the centers and you join the centers, so if I join all the centers, it will make axis, and we call that as axis of rotation. Now, rigid body is understood. Rotational axis is also understood, axis of rotation. Now we'll consider how this linear velocity and angular velocity varies. As we move away, for this particle, this is the radius. For this particle, this is the radius. Suppose this is particle number 1, this is particle number 2, and this is particle number 3. I don't consider this one. you can see that the radius of first particle, second particle and third particle, the radius of first particle is suppose r1, second particle radius is suppose r2 and third one r3. This is the radius. Then it is obviously clear, as is seen, that r3 is greater than r2 is greater than r1. As suppose this body is rotating with a constant angular velocity omega, then each and every point on the body will also make an rotation, and angular velocity will also be omega, because all the points have to reach at the same point again after the same given interval of time, because the body has to maintain its own shape. So this point also will take the same omega, would move with the same omega, this point also moves same omega, any point here also it will have the same omega, each and every point will have same omega in rotational motion. The radius is different, but we know that v equals to omega r. If I use that, then v1 for the first particle, the velocity is v1, so v1 is omega r1, because omega is constant now, omega is same for all particles in rotational motion. This is an important point. So if I write about omega, it will be same for all three particles, radius is different, and obviously v equals to omega r, then omega is fixed, r is different, then v has to be different, because omega has to be constant. If r increases, v also will increase, because now v is proportional to r. Greater r means greater v. v2, omega r2, and here v3 will be omega r3. Omega being same, r3 is more, so v3 is more. That means the particle which is lying away, more and farther away from the axis of rotation, will have to have a greater speed. So this is what is the conclusion from this concept, that more the value of r implies more of linear velocity. So more r implies more v, but more r doesn't imply more omega. More r doesn't imply more omega, more r implies same omega. This is what you have to understand. Okay, so this is how varies, linear velocity varies directly with the radius. And if you want to plot the graph of that, v equals to omega r, if I want to plot the graph of velocity versus r, how this velocity is changing for a given object as I move from here to different points from the axis of rotation to other points, this is r. So my starting point is here, my end point is here, suppose. Then v is increasing gradually, and that has to be linear relationship, because this is a theta, and tan theta is your omega now, slope of this graph. So it is a linear relationship. This v also increases at a steady rate, it's a constant rate, the slope is constant, v is increasing, is an equation of a straight line. Now, and what about the omega? Omega, if I want to plot the graph of omega, no problem with that. The omega graph versus r is starting with this omega, initial omega, suppose omega naught, then this after whichever point you choose on this one, this will have the same omega, it will be like that. This is a constant, this is a Kelvin constant slope. This is how you plot the graph for these variations. So let us go to another concept. So far, this is the concept. Thank you.